Welcome back to Google Developers Live at I.O. Louis Gray here with Daniel Sieberg.
That's right. And you know, one of the big mentions of the keynote yesterday was, of course, Google Maps.
Yes.
We saw a lot of big updates and refreshes. And so yesterday, I got a chance to go to the sandbox here. Some amazing stuff going on. I think
right.
It's fascinating what people are doing tying into the Maps API.
We're short on time before the next
session. Yes, we are.
So what we're going to do is we're going to go right to that interview that took place with the sandbox yesterday. Let's go ahead and roll that video.
Hi there, I'm Daniel Sieberg with Google Developers Live here at I.O. 2013, and we find ourselves in the Maps sandbox, and I'm joined right now by Menno Marks, who is the lead developer advocate on the Maps team.
That's right.
And we're going to be talking about Nintendo's Wii Street U. So I want you to sort of walk us through what this is all about and obviously bring in Ryan here from Nintendo.
Sure, so hi, I'm Menno. This is Ryan Lind from Nintendo showing off the Wii U, which has a great new Street View application using the Wii U and the Wii U controller. So do you want to walk us through it?
Yes, please. Thank you, Matt. So what we have here is we have Wii Street U. This is a free application available on the Nintendo Wii U console. You can download it today from eShop. And what it is it's an application written in HTML5 and JavaScript using the Nintendo Web Framework. And that allowed us to kind of really rapidly iterate on this application, as well as use the great Google Maps APIs to bring in the Maps data and really kind of make it a very interactive experience with the Wii Street U and the Street View data. So I'm just going to walk you through this application a little bit. So what we have is, first thing is I'm going to take you on a tour. And so I'm going to load up on the gamepad here some recommended spots. And we're going to go ahead and jump over to Florence, Italy. And what you can see down here on the gamepad is that I can navigate the Street View information very naturally with the gyroscope information from the gamepad controller. And you can see that we have really smooth motion. I can go ahead and start navigating down this Italian street. And all of this information is stored in the Google Maps servers. And it's really great that when we designed and worked with this application, we had all of this content available to us, all of these really good imagery that we could just kind of put an interface on top of. One of the new features that we just enabled in the application is integration with Miiverse, which is Nintendo's social platform. And so I'm going to go ahead and give you a demonstration of that. So this allows you to, when you find a location or a spot that's really interesting, you can kind of flag it and upload it to the Miiverse servers and share it with your friends or share it with the community so that they can find those spots later. So I'm going to select latest posts. And these are posts that have been shared live by users of Wii Street U now.
So Mano, talk to me a little bit about the working with Nintendo, what that was like. I mean, is this kind of a very unique way of seeing this free view imagery through a gaming console?
Yeah, well, it was a really exciting partnership because their platform is based on web, so they're actually using the JavaScript APIs to build this. So this is something, theoretically, that anybody who had their own platform and the right licenses could do using the Google Maps API. So yeah, it's an inspiring use, and I love to see the coordination between the different devices there. So you've got the controller and the Wii itself displaying up here. Yeah, it's a really great implementation.
Great. I just want to know when Mario is going to show up in one of the street view seats.
All right. No, we take feature requests, but I can't promise that we'll get him in.
Okay, right. Cool. Great. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate
it. Thank you.
All right, we're going to dive into our next partner now. In fact, we're going to map dive into our next partner. This is a new term that I'm learning here. Mano joins me again, and Ben from Instrument. So, Mano, talk to me a little bit about what we're seeing behind us. I know that these are familiar to Googlers, this Liquid Galaxy display.
Right.
But this is a unique way of presenting it.
So Liquid Galaxy is actually a collection of hardware. We actually open source the plans on how to build this. So anybody could theoretically build this as long as they're willing to invest in the hardware. And it's a way of getting a bunch of different computers and screens to synchronize together so you can do this kind of large-scale display. And the Instrument folks have done a great application called Google Map Dive, and you can actually see this in the background, and this is all using HTML5 and the JavaScript API.
That's
so
right.
Why don't you tell us a little bit more about it.
All right, so what you're seeing behind me here is all running in Google Chrome. We've got 7 separate instances of Chrome, each running on a separate PC. And they're all being synchronized through WebSockets. The game itself is running on an additional machine that's hidden behind these displays here. And it's sort of keeping track of the game state and then broadcasting that out to all 7 of the display nodes over WebSockets. And so the 3D game content that you see in the foreground is a WebGL layer with a transparent background. And then behind that, we have a live HTML Google Maps region that is transformed using 3D CSS. And so using 3.js, we're able to synchronize the camera between the WebGL view and the 3D CSS view. And so what we get is this really cohesive scene. We're able to stitch the image between all 7 monitors just by offsetting the camera between each display.
So this is an entirely accurate representation of Google Maps. I mean, this is
you're seeing a live Google Map.
Yeah, and in fact, the first question a lot of people ask you is this term compliant?
Yes,
right?
It is term compliant. We're not accessing tiles directly. That if I hadn't turned off the user interface events, you'd be able to drag that map around if you had a mouse. So what the reason it looks a little non-traditional is that we've used the styling API extensively to create these sort of custom themes for each of the maps. But it is an actual Google map. The way we're doing the sky haze, that kind of causes some sort of suspicion. That's an OpenGL layer in the WebGL view that's simply fading from transparent to the sky color that we've chosen. And that way we hide the hard edges of the corners.
Clearly this is a lot of fun, and a lot of people like us would like it in their living room.
Uh-huh.
What's the future of this? Where is it going?
Well, our plan right now is to clean up the code a little bit and sort of get it running in a single browser instance. Right now it's sort of distributed where we have the server and the client separate and sort of talking over WebSockets. But we're going to do some refactoring and get it running in a single browser window, and then we'd like to release it and open source it and maybe put it up on Chrome experiments or something like that.
Where does this rank in the uniqueness of some of the partners are doing? I mean, this seems pretty awesome.
This is pretty high up. Yeah, I think we've got a really great sandbox this year. This is pretty pretty amazing, pretty impressive. So, yeah. I'm really, really great to see this.
Yeah, you should. I don't know if you're watching this remotely, but if you are here somewhere, you should come and play it. It's a lot of fun.
Exactly. Yeah. All right, cool. Ben, thank you so much.
Sure. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Ben.
Well, I forgot that I loaned my car out to do this next demo, I wish. We're actually over at the Mercedes-Benz part of the Maps Sandbox. I'm joined by now by Chris from Mercedes-Benz to talk about some really cool navigation features that are built into this car. First of all, what are we sitting in right now?
So right now this is an SL550.
Okay.
It's a pretty payment, so.
Yeah, it's on the wish list.
All right, it's on the wish list.
Tell me about the screen that we're looking at right here and what it can do.
So this current screen, we want to show off our Google APIs that we've implemented into this app. All this right now is powered by your smartphone. All the cellular data, all the network requests are going over the cellular data. And so we basically just use this head unit just for drawing stuff. And so this place is powered by Google Tile that we have here. What it does is it takes away the tedious address entry of enter in your city, enter in your state, enter in your house number. So what we can do here is we can select this tile,
okay,
and we can set a destination. So for example, let's just type in 8, like we want to go to 88 Howard.
Yep.
And so what we do, we type in 8 and it auto-completes each time we type in a letter. And this takes away us having to enter in the location, the city, the street, and all that stuff.
Right. And all of this is being done with this jog wheel down here?
Right, yeah, we call it a CCE, but rotary knob, whatever you want to call it. Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
So we can just type in a random address, so let's do like 56.
Yep.
And 56th Street.
So it's already suggesting ones that would
work. Correct, so it's 562 Sutter Street.
Okay.
We can select this, and now what we can do is we can view street view of this location.
Okay.
And now since we have a rotary knob here, what we can do is do a whole 360 degrees of the street view, which allows for a very intuitive kind of experience.
So you can really see, before you even get there, what to expect.
Correct. And yeah, it's just an awesome feature. It really helps to be able to just to quickly go through the tiles that are returned.
Okay, great.
Another feature we have is the View on Map feature. And so this uses the Google Maps SDK. And what it does is allows you to see the general area of the POI. So you can zoom out, you can zoom in. And if you zoom in far enough, you get the pretty little 3D buildings that, you know, makes it,
Sure. Yeah. Just like you would on a mobile device.
Exactly. So this gives you a general idea of where stuff is.
Okay.
And so this search can also handle categories. So what we can do is we can search general pizza. So this will actually return us results of all the pizza places that are currently around us. It gives us the star rating that is returned, the price, and the distance from us. So for example, we'll select this pizza place, and it gives us a couple more details, such as when it's opened, and we can actually call the place too, if we wanted to pre-order our pizza.
Great.
It gives us the same features as street viewing it on the map, and also photos.
User-generated photos?
So these are user-generated photos that are uploaded to Google. Someone had a very good green onion pizza here.
Yeah.
And you can just scroll through them just to see if you want to go to that place.
Okay.
And that covers our autocomplete feature. Okay. Another feature we want to highlight on is our traffic. This also uses the Google Maps SDK. It's just like your typical experience when you're looking at Google traffic on the web or the browser. You know what the color lines are. While you're driving, you can, you know, pan around, see what the traffic is on the bridge.
Yep.
Zoom in on the bridge just in case, you know, you don't see the right color.
Doesn't look too bad right now.
Doesn't look too bad.
Yep.
It will later, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Everyone's going home.
Yeah. All right, let's move on. We've just got a little time left. If you can show us the last
feature. So the last thing is a city guide.
Yep.
So what this is it allows you just to view a variety of categories around you. So you can say, I want to know the nightlife around me. And so you can select this, and it returns basically, as you know, a weather map. You know, green means light, red means heavy. In this case, white means heavy. So you know underneath that white little area, there's a lot of nightlife. And so you can go there.
Cool. All right, put your seatbelts on. We're out of here.
Thank
you so much, Chris. Yeah. That's going to do it for here at the Maps Sandbox with Google Developers Live. Stay tuned for lots more content right here.
Well, I think I'm going to become a professional map diver after that. And just a quick shout out, if you want to check out the new Google Maps, remember to go to maps.google.com/preview and sign up.
Great, thanks for the preview. We'll be right back at 2:20 to talk Chromebook Pixel. Enjoy your sessions.